Ready? Start. The appellant, a private limited company, had auctioned a number of paintings on 20th November 2002. Two paintings were purchased by Messer Tony Haynes of England. The said two paintings were to be exported. The customs authorities had detained these paintings on the suspicion that the said paintings were antiques within the meaning of the provisions of the Antiquities and Art Treasures Act 1972, hereinafter referred to as the Act. The said paintings were examined by Deputy Superintendent Archaeology Customs Archaeological Survey of India on 7 January 2003 and having opined that the paintings were antiques referred the matter to the Director General Archaeological Survey of India for final opinion under Section 24 of the Act. The said paintings were seized by the department. This was followed by a complaint dated 6th January 2004 by Superintendent Archaeologist Antique addressed to the Superintendent of Police CBI, in which it is inter alia stated that after examination of the said two paintings, they were found to be antique in nature. After receiving the complaint, further verification was conducted by the CBI. On verification of facts, the CBI found prima facie the commission of offence under Section 3 of the Act punishable under Section 25 of the said Act. The CBI accordingly registered the FIR on 29th January 2004 under Section 120B IPC, read with Section 25, read with Section 3 of the Act. The CBI, after investigation, filed the charge sheet against the appellant's company who purchased the said paintings in the auction. Be it noted that after the filing of charge sheet, the appellants filed writ petition civil number 16 of 2004 in Delhi High Court challenging the report of Director General ASI and for directing the customs authorities not to proceed in the matter on the basis of the order passed by the adjudicating authority directing confiscation of the said two paintings under the Customs Act. In the said writ petition, the petitioner clearly admitted the factum of CBI registering FIR, and copy of the said FIR was also made available for the perusal of the court. It may be noted that by the time the said writ petition came to be filed, CBI had filed its charge sheet on 24th August 2004, yet the petitioner had not chosen to challenge the FIR and the charge sheet filed by the CBI. The said writ petition was disposed of by a consent order directing the competent authority to pass a fresh order on the basis of fresh report submitted by a fresh committee. It was agreed by the Archaeological Survey of India in that writ petition to reconstitute a committee for the examination of the paintings and to pass a fresh order in regard to the matter in controversy. It may also be noted that CBI was not even implicated as a party respondent in the writ petition. That in compliance of the order dated 24th March 2005, a committee consisting of 6 members was constituted to examine the said paintings. The committee gave a fractured verdict due to which the competent authority could not give a final opinion. The appellants again moved another writ petition, civil number 56 of 2006, before Delhi High Court seeking appropriate directions against the ASI so as not to give effect to undated minutes of meetings dated 26th July 2005 on various grounds with which we are not concerned for the present in these appeals. The High Court wide order dated 28th April 2006 disposed of the writ petition directing the Director General ASI to pass an order in terms of the decision of the Division Bench dated 24th March 2005 and granted stay of the prosecution till expiry of 30 days after the fresh determination decision of Director General. The ASI thereafter filed writ petition numbers 203 of 2005 resulting in the impugned order. It is interesting to note that in the present writ petition to relief prayed for is to quash the FIR and not the order passed by the trial court refusing to discharge the appellants from a criminal case filed by the CBI. The writ petition is mainly based on the ground that the basis of the FIR, the earlier report of Archaeological Survey of India, has been rendered redundant in view of the decision rendered by the Division Bench.